Thank you for joining us for this special edition of the NIH Grants Policy Update. This video is focusing on the topic of expiring appropriations and what it means for you. We know you're busy with a to-do list that probably includes carryover items from yesterday and last week, or maybe even beyond. But somehow you have to squeeze in time to learn the latest policy information for your role in working with the NIH grants process. So we're here to help with a 10-minute video update, two NIH experts, and four questions highlighting our topic. On behalf of the National Institutes of Health, I'm Cynthia Dwyer from NIH's Office of Extramural Research, your moderator for this Q&A. Our experts on the topic are Ms. Michelle Bowles, Director of the NIH Office of Policy for Extramural Research Administration, and Mr. Alan Whatley, Lead Accountant in the NIH Office of Financial Management. We recently sat down to discuss why NIH grant recipients need to be aware of expiring balances and the importance of deadlines, such as the cash transaction report on June 30th and the end of the federal government fiscal year date of September 30th. Within the next 10 minutes, we'll provide excerpts from this previously recorded interview.
With the end of the fiscal year approaching, we're starting to hear more and more about expiring balances. Ms. Bowles, can you tell us some more background on what expiring balances, what they are, and why recipients need to be aware of them?
Thank you, Cynthia, for asking that question. Grants and cooperative agreements funds follow the rules for the availability of appropriated funds and balances when accounting for annual and multi-year appropriation accounts that are expired. NIH funds most grants and cooperative agreements in 12-month incremental budget periods. Each budget period is funded with dollars appropriated for that specific fiscal year in which the award is made. So by law, these funds are only available until the end, September 30th, of the fifth fiscal year after the funds are awarded, unless authority has been given to the agency to liquidate the obligations under a longer period. Any balances that remain at the time will be canceled and returned to Treasury. And this requirement is in the law 31 U.S.C. 1552A that we also outline in the NIH Grants Policy Statement under Section 8, which also is a term and condition for all awards, which is why it's very important for our recipients to monitor and review the terms and conditions carefully, as NIH grants management offices within the ICs identify these requirements of expiring balances to ensure that the funds are appropriately used and liquidated before the funds become unavailable.
Thank you, Ms. Bowles. I can see why recipients would need to be aware of expiring balances, since no one wants to get their money sent back if it can be used to support research. Mr. Whatley, can you address how a recipient would know that they have expiring funds?
At the end of fiscal year 2018, funds awarded in fiscal year 2013 will expire. And so on, you know, accordingly, FY2014 funds will expire at the end of fiscal year 2019. Fiscal year 2015 funds will expire at the end of fiscal year 2020, etc. So as you can see, this is an annual occurrence. But for the current year that we're dealing with, this is FY2018, and fiscal year 2013 funds will expire at the end of this current fiscal year. If you are unsure when funds were awarded, you can always look at the fiscal year information in PMS or the Notice of Award. The Payment Management System will show you which fiscal year your award came out of, and the Notice of Award will show that same information, the exact fiscal year that your award came out of. The NIH Office of Financial Management also sends a grants expiring letter to recipients if an unexpended balance of funds is about to expire. These letters are sent electronically to the same email as the NOA. And just to expand a little bit on those expiring letters, the letters are sent out in April of each year, so it's an annual process. And the letters contain a notification that an expiring balance exists and instructions on the steps necessary to liquidate the balance properly. This would happen through an FFR submission to NIH or an adjustment to the quarterly expenditure report submitted to the payment management system. If you have an expiring balance, you also may hear from your grants management specialist, since they're receiving regular reports from the Office of Financial Management regarding expiring balances.
Thank you, Mr. Whatley. So once a recipient is aware of an expiring balance, what do they need to do? Is it as simple as just spending all of the money by September 30th?
Unfortunately, it's not that easy. Our internal accounting system, NBS, will cancel all remaining FY13 funds on September 30th, 2018. That means recipients must report all of their expenditures, meaning their final expenditures, on their June 30th quarterly cash transaction report in PMS. This will ensure that all funds are accounted for prior to September 30th when the funds actually expire. Recipients should always be spending their grant funds first in, first out, to ensure that prior fiscal year funds are being spent before current year money, as that is how PMS reports the disbursements on a first in, first out basis. So if you're awarded multiple years, PMS will always fully disperse the prior years before it starts to disperse the subsequent years. So your internal records should reflect the same thing.
So if I'm a recipient, what happens if I miss my deadline and my funds are canceled? Can my awarding institute or center restore those funds?
It's crucial that recipients work to utilize the funds that were authorized before they expire and submit timely cash transaction reports in the payment management system. Once the funds have expired and are canceled, they can no longer be used nor reobligated, which is why it's so important for recipients to monitor and pay close attention to the terms and conditions of their award. The only time funds are not canceled is when the agency receives authorization to utilize them for a longer period of time. Therefore, any restoration of funds would have to come out of the IC's current year budget.
That's right, Michelle. Even though PMS will let recipients draw down until September the 27th, you can't wait that long to draw your NIH funds from fiscal year 2013. Our system needs the data in the June 30th PMS quarterly report in order to accurately clear expired funds on September 30th. If you have expiring funds, you need to decide what to do with them as soon as possible.
Absolutely.
And with that final piece of advice, we're going to wrap up the conversation on this topic. Hopefully you can now mark one more of those items on your checklist off and feel that you're a little more knowledgeable about expiring appropriations and important deadlines associated with them. If you have specific questions on this topic, please email the NIH Division of Grants Policy at grantspolicy@mail.nih.gov. If you have comments regarding this video or would like to suggest future topics, we welcome your suggestions at oer@od.nih.gov. And thank you.